Hello everyone, in this class we will discuss about computation of cost of perpetual debt or perpetual debentures. So before starting with the problem, let us now understand example on par, premium and discount. So I think you might heard this word par, premium and discount. So I will tell you what exactly this par, premium and discount with the help of one example. So par means face value of debenture. Okay, so assume that face value of the debenture is 100 rupees. So this 100 rupees we call it as par. So now premium means more than face value of debenture. So in first one, that is par, face value is 100 rupees. Premium is more than that 100 rupees. It might be 110. So third one, discount means less than face value of debenture. So discount in the sense it is less than face value of the debenture. So face value of the debenture in this example is 100 rupees. So less than face value means it might be 90 rupees. So this is one example on par, premium and discount. So let us now move towards one example. So that is A. Before that we will understand what exactly the formula is. If the debenture are issued at par, so at that time, just to refer here, if the debentures are issued at par, the cost of perpetual debentures can be calculated by adopting the following formula. So formula is KD is equal to R into 1 minus T, where KD is equal to cost of debt, R is equal to rate of interest, T is equal to tax rate. So this is the formula when debentures are issued at par, at that time we have to apply. So let us now understand with the help of one example. Example 1. X Limited issued 10% perpetual debenture at par, that is at rupees 100. The tax rate is 50%. Here they have given 10% perpetual debenture at par, that is at rupees 100 rupees. So the tax rate they have given 50%. So with the help of this information, we have to put these values in the formula. So the cost of debt in this case will be KD is equal to R into bracket 1 minus T, where KD is equal to cost of debt, that we have to identify. So that is why I inserted a question mark. So R is equal to rate of interest, that is they have given in the problem, that is 10%. So if we convert it into decimal, that is 10 divided by 100, it becomes 0.10. So T is equal to tax rate, that is 50%, they have given in the problem. So if we convert this percentage into decimal, that is 50 divided by 100, again it will comes to 0.50. So these value we have to put it in the formula. So KD is equal to R, that is 0.10 into bracket 1 minus 0.50. Okay, so now KD is equal to, so 10 into 0.50, so KD is equal to 5% will come. So this is the answer for this question. Okay, so now let us move towards next example. So before that, let us now understand what is the formula to calculate premium. That is, if the debentures are issued at premium, that is KD is equal to R divided by P into bracket 1 minus T, where KD is equal to cost of debt, R is equal to rate of interest, P is equal to net proceeds, T is equal to tax rate. So C1, if the debentures are issued at discount, so KD is equal to R divided by P into 1 minus T, where KD is equal to cost of debt, R is equal to rate of interest, P is equal to net proceeds, T is equal to tax rate. I think these two formulas are same, just to refer here. So now we will understand with the help of one example. So example here, so example on debenture issued at discount. So example 2, A Limited issued 10% perpetual debentures at rupees 90. The tax rate is 50%. The cost of debt in this case will be, solution, KD is equal to R divided by P into bracket 1 minus T, where KD is equal to cost of debt, R is equal to rate of interest, P is equal to net proceeds, T is equal to tax rate. So this is the formula. So now we have to put these values in the formula. So KD is equal to 10 divided by 100 into 1 minus 0.5. So KD is equal to 10 into, if we simplify this, so its answer becomes 10 into 0.5 divided by 90. So KD is equal to 0.50 divided by 90. So KD is equal to 5.56%. So this is the answer. So again, we will solve another example on debentures issued at a premium. So on that we will solve one problem. So example 3, A Limited issued 10% perpetual debentures at a premium of 10%. The tax rate is 50%. The cost of capital in this case will be KD is equal to R divided by P into 1 minus T, where KD is equal to cost of debt, R is equal to rate of interest, P is equal to net proceeds, T is equal to tax rate. So KD is equal to 10 divided by 110 into 1 minus 0.50. So KD is equal to 10 divided by 110 into 0.50. So KD is equal to 5 divided by 11. So KD, that is cost of debt, is equal to 4.55 is the answer. So thank you.